Assalamu alaikum, dear students. You all know that due to coronavirus infection, Government of Pakistan has suspended all the classes at different educational institutions. That's why we are not having our regular classes. But the higher authorities of Akhtar Said Medical and Dental College have requested us to deliver online lectures, so your curricular time is not wasted. So we have planned to record these lectures online, and then I will communicate them through Facebook, and you can also access them through portal system of Akhtar Said Medical and Dental College. So we have been discussing since last night that the lectures will be delivered to you on time, and your online attendance will be marked, and it will be included in your internal assessment. So today we are going to start with a new topic, which is demography. And from examination point of view, it is very, very important. We have selected this time for demography because we thought that the supply students will be back with us. But unfortunately, the classes have been suspended. We cannot further delay it. So I will request you to pay full attention to these lectures. So demos means people and graphy means studies. So it's a scientific study which revolves around people. So we can define it as a study of human population. We are much concerned about the size of human population because the size of the population does not only affect the socio-economic growth of that area, but it also affects the disease pattern. So as the population of whole world is increasing day by day, and with increasing population there is trend towards urbanization, and with urbanization major problems of pollution like soil pollution, air pollution, noise pollution, radiation pollution are coming into existence. That's why we are much more concerned that which part of the world has a larger number of population, which part of the world has lower number of population, and how the size affects the disease pattern of that area. In demography, we are also concerned about the distribution of the population. We want to know that what is the sex structure of the population, how many males, how many females. We want to know that how this population is distributed in different parts of the world. For example, if we talk about the population of Pakistan, we know that 70% of the population lies in the areas which are rural areas, and only 31% of the population lies in the urban areas. So we are much more concerned about the disease pattern in the urban population and in the rural population, because we all know that in urbanization we have modern diseases. For example, cardiovascular diseases, diabetes and hypertension, these are much more prevalent in the urban population as compared to rural population, where most of the diseases are from the communicable diseases, and these diseases which can emerge because of the poor socioeconomic development and because of the poor hygienic conditions. We want to know that what is the age distribution of the population, because the age affects the disease pattern as well. As we all know that there are certain diseases which are much more prevalent in the population of less than 5 years of age, and we all know that diarrhea and upper respiratory tract infections, measles, malaria cause major mortality in the population of the lower age group. Then we have the age group which comes in the adolescent age group, and we all know that the in the urban population we have drug abuse, we have smoking, we have depressions, we have suicidal tendencies in the adolescent population in the urban settings. And then reproductive age group, where the females need much more attention because they carry pregnancy and they deliver babies and they go into the postpartum period, which is a major portion where mortality and morbidity can occur. So we are interested in knowing not only the age structure, but we also want to know about the gender structure or gender distribution of the population as well. So in a nutshell, I will say that demography revolves around the size, distribution and structure of the human population, because they affect the disease pattern, and that's why we are much more interested in this study. So, how will you define population? The population is defined as the total number of people in a given area in a given period of time. And while describing population of a country, we want to know that how it is distributed, what is the age distribution, what is the gender distribution, what is the rural urban population, in case of provincial distribution, what is the population distribution in case of provinces, etc., etc. These all parameters are discussed in case of demography. When we talk about the population process, you can very well see that there are three major processes which affect the population of a country, which include, number one, births. As we all know, that births continuously increase the population of a country, and those countries who have high birth rates show increasing trends in population in the coming years. As we all know that there are certain countries, for example Kenya, for example Pakistan and India, we report that there is high birth rate, and in coming years, in next 30 to 35 years, the population will be doubled. So we are much more concerned about the birth rates. We are also concerned about the death rates. And in the early era, there was high birth rate and high death rate. The high death rate was because of the prevalence of many communicable diseases and pandemics, which causes high mortality rates. And there were high birth rates because the family planning methods were not introduced and the people were not willing to opt it. So in compensation, the high birth rate was compensated with the high death rate. But in the current prevailing conditions, we have a little bit higher birth rate, and in some countries the birth rate has been reduced, and we have also reduced our death rate because of the provision of the healthcare services. So that's why the population is continuously increasing, because the pandemics have been controlled, the healthcare service provision has improved, the age, the life expectancy has been improved, and the people are living much longer. For a longer period of time. That's why the births and deaths are continuously affecting the population increase. And then another process which affects the population of a country is migration. We all know that there are internal migrations and there are external migrations. In the early phase of life, internal migrations are much more common, where the people from the rural area migrate to the urban area for better opportunities of education and better opportunities of jobs. And then after the adolescent age group, in the age group which is mostly the reproductive age group and the productive age group, external migrations are much more common. So we experience in migrations and out migrations both, which can affect a process. You can very well imagine, looking into this graph, that at the age of 35 to 44 years, where majority of the population is settling and they are producing children, they are going outward, for they are moving towards the outer migration. Out migration is much more common there. Why? Because they want to have much more opportunities for earning. But in case of the other age groups, you can see that the in-migration is much more common in the inner settings. So when we talk about the population structure of a country, we want to know the age distribution. As we all know that in Pakistan, the population pyramid shows the broader base, which means that a majority of the population is under 15 years of age because we have high birth rates. We want to know that what is the sex distribution, because the according to the equity, we need to define our resources according to the gender distribution. We all know that in the female age group, of reproductive age group, we have to give much more service provision to the female. So we want to know that how many females are in the reproductive age group, how many males are there in the productive age group. Then we want to know the race of the population, because race most of the times affect the population disease pattern. As we all know that Caucasians have a major tendency towards development of stomach cancers. The Asian population female population has a major tendency to develop breast cancers. So we know that what is the racial distribution of the population. We also want to know the ethnicity of the population. And why ethnicity? Because of the ethnic groups and because of the cultural values of different ethnic groups, disease pattern changes. For example, the population which lives in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, they are much more towards the eating habits of having much more meat and fats, etc. So there's much more tendency of developing colon cancers and other cancers in that population. For example, in our Sindhi population, there is a habit of having niswar, or oral tobacco chewing is much more common in the population. So we want to know that how the ethnicity is distributed in the population, and we want to know that how it affects the disease pattern. When we talk about the population structure, we also want to know that what is the proportion of the population which is residing below the poverty line? What is the proportion of the population which is earning to meet the both ends meet? What is the percentage of the population which is residing in the upper socioeconomic group? Because the socioeconomic status also affects the disease pattern. As we all know that the chronic diseases are much more common in the upper socioeconomic group, and the infectious diseases are much more common in the lower socioeconomic group. We also want to know that how the population is distributed according to the marital status. As after marriages, there are much more needs for the reproductive health services. So these are the parameters which affect the population structure. And as demographic investigator, we want to know that how the population is distributed according to this distribution. How do we get the demographic data? There are multiple sources through which we can collect data from the population. And one of the most important source of demographic data is census. And then we have surveys, then we have registrations of birth and deaths and marriages. And there are multiple other sources which can help us in collection of demographic data. In Pakistan, we have census, we have multiple Pakistan demographic health surveys, we have registration system, which is NADRA, which not only registers births and deaths, but it also registers the marriages. And we have population registers with us. We have service statistics that what is the OPD number, what is the inpatient number, how many percentage of the population is using family planning methods, what is the percentage of the population which is actually taking services from the hepatitis B control program or hepatitis C control program, etc. And etc. We have international migration statistics which are maintained at the airport and at the ministries of the foreign affairs, where we know that how much in migration and out migration is being done. We conduct many researches in which the quantitative data and qualitative data is collected, and through the collection of these data, we also we assess that how much a population is affected by different diseases and what is the pattern of population as well. So let's talk about the census. Census is basically collecting, compiling, and publishing demographic data, economic data, and social data. The two important things about census is that it is conducted in specific times. As WHO says that census should be conducted every 10 years. Another important feature of census is that all the persons of the country are included in census. So we do not miss even a single household during census. So it gives a complete picture of the population of a country. It is conducted after every 10 years. Census are different from surveys because the census covers the whole population of a country. We take statistics from the census that these are the parameters, that this is the total number of population, this is the age distribution, this is the socioeconomic distribution, this is the ethnicity of the population. But in case of surveys, we only take a small sample from the whole population, and then we calculate the statistics from the sample. In case of that gap, which is of 10 years, in between the 10 years of two census, we conduct different surveys in which we take samples, and then from samples we calculate statistics, and these statistics are then sent are then give the projected values of the total census.